Are plenty of them starting off in the first period. Less than 2 minutes into the game, Logan O'Connor off a nice feed from Newhook.
Well, the D's start this. They're smooth. They get out easy. Newhook drives down, hits the late guy, and a great shot. It might have been tipped, but it was still a good shot by O'Connor.
Yeah, and I mean, you can just see it. Newhook is starting to feel more confident as well. O'Connor brings that speed. He's in the right spot, and he makes it count. And then the Avs get themselves into the spot they really want on the power play, but it's the second unit that shows up.
Yeah, they almost, like you said, Columbus almost had it killed with the first unit, and they come out with these 3D. I love it. They can all move the puck. They all have good vision. Gerard makes a great play back. Guess who's in front? Compher. He can tip. That's a good tip. He made it look easy, but that's not an easy tip.
And hard to imagine that was actually his first goal of the year, but we've been seeing him. He had a really strong game all over the board tonight, so love to see that from JT. And then we get to the second period, less than 35 seconds this time, and he would end up being the hero, but Mikko Rantanen off a nice pass from Rodriguez. He just stances the goalie straight out of that crease, Adam.
I love it. Most thought he should have had that one, but this is a goal scorer's goal. McKinnon's pressure, nice little pass from Rodriguez. This guy waits him out. Granted, and that net opens up. Goal scorers in hockey will know what I'm talking about. I wasn't one of them, but, you know, I saw Joe do this quite a few times, and Mikko made a lot of patience there. Great goal.
Yeah, and it was actually a really great play from McKinnon to start it off. But then Columbus gets their shot on the power play, and they score for the first time this year, and suddenly they're feeling pretty good.
They are. Faceoffs all year got to get a little bit better for the Avs, but they win it clean, and guess who's got the puck in the right spot is hard, heavy shot. Voracek, another nice tip. Not much we can do on that one, but this changed momentum of the game. It seemed like Columbus needed that. It was their first one, first power play goal of the year. And then again, you give this guy time and space. The Finn, he's got a shot, and he loaded it up here, and it was a hard one. Don't know where that's going to go as a goalie, but it would end up going 5-0.
Yeah, Patrick Laine, you give him that much room, and credit to Gaudreau for being strong along the blue line there, but from the top of the circle, absolutely blasts it through the 5-hole. Really not sure there was much Georgiev could do. Either way, it takes us to the third period where Columbus continues to roll with the momentum they had from the second. It's a 3-3 game after a goal from Sean Corrali. See some nice passes. At first they thought it might have been from Foodie, but Corrali gets the credit for that one, and suddenly we're all tied up.
Well, Columbus is happy. Larson, Coach Larson's got to be happy. Their fourth line gets a goal here. But, I mean, it's the Avs, too. You spend a little bit too much time in your end. It's the weak side defenseman or the weak side player has just lost the man. Maybe it was a bad bounce. But Columbus is there. They're back in it. And that's when the Avs go, nope, here we go.
Yeah, they woke
power
up.
Play goal. And, you know, they're just too potent. They're deep, like Riker said. And this shot is, again, I'm going to use the term a goal scorer's goal. He just bombs this in. He was feeling it from the drop of the puck, you could tell. And at the end, he couldn't wipe the smile off.
Yeah, no question. And, you know, just for good measure, and actually something we've all been just dying to see, finally, Cale Makar, you can see he's pretty excited, gets his first of the season. It has been a long time coming, and that made it 5-3.
Well, hey, you know what? He's going to score a lot of goals in this league for a long time. But
yes,
when it's been 10 games or whatever the number is without one, this is going to make him feel good. And he might just get a hat trick tomorrow, though I did say it might be low scoring.
And then, of course, the empty netter to complete the hat trick. But not lost in this play is the unselfishness of Nathan McKinnon. Really wanted to make sure his friend got that one. Sends it up top. Mikko Rantanen, 3 goals on the night. The hats come flying down, and the Finnish fans got exactly what they wanted.
Did McKinnon make a lot of fans and friends in Finland tonight with that one, giving it to Mikko there?
Yeah.
It's an unselfish play, and for McKinnon, that's what his teammates love. He'll turn up.